Dear all, this video discusses how to find cross correlation between two sequences in MATLAB. So, correlation is basically used to find the correlation between two sequences or relationship between two sequences. So, we have two types, that is autocorrelation and cross correlation. Autocorrelation is discussed in the previous video. Now, in cross correlation, the formula is given as, in autocorrelation, we find out the relationship between two same sequence, but in cross correlation, the correlation is found out between two other sequences. That is, we here correlation is found out between x of n one sequence and y of minus n another sequence. So basically, it is basically convoluting a given sequence into the other sequence, reflected sequence. So this can also be written as summation k equal to minus infinity to infinity x of k into y of n plus k. So instead of convoluting with the same sequence, here another sequence is considered, and as it is minus n, it has been inverted. So now consider, for example, the sequence x is equal to 3 4 5 6 and y equal to 1 3 4 5. It is so similar to linear convolution, but the second sequence has been inverted. So in order to do this, so we can use the very simple method of linear convolution. So writing 3 4 5 6 over here, and the sequence is been flipped. So that is, it becomes 5 4 3 1. X of minus n means it is like the mirror image. So flipping it. So write instead of 1 3 4 5, write it in the reverse order, 5 4 3 1. And just similar to how linear convolution was done, which was discussed in previous video. So just solve it using the same method, and then drawing these lines and finding out the sum of each of it, we get the final result like this. So this is obtained by multiplying each row and column elements. That is 5 into 3 15, 5 into 4 20, similarly 4 into 3 12. So like this, each rows are found out, and then it has been summed. Now in order to implement this in MATLAB, so like any other program, the program starts with CLC, which is used to clear command window. Then clear all is used to clear the variables. Close all is used to close the previously open figure window. Then input is used to enter the sequence. So first sequence is entered. Then in order to find the length of the input, the command is length of x. And in order to find enter the second sequence h, that is enter the second sequence input, again find the length of h. Now as the equation is y of minus n, so the second sequence has to be flipped. So in order to flip, the command is flip LR of H, which is already discussed in autocorrelation. And then find the cross correlation using convolution function. So conv of x comma y, and display the results. Now here also, in order to verify using built-in function, the same command can be used. Only thing is, the sequences are different. X core of x comma h, and display it using disp function. Now the same program can be written very similar to linear cross correlation. Can also be found out using the same formula used for linear convolution. So the length in linear convolution is given by lx plus lh minus 1. Now in order to implement the equation, considering the outer loop, that is n equal to 1 to length, and initializing the variable rxs, so rxs of n is equal to 0. And now for k equal to 1 to lx, check whether n minus k is between the value 0 and lh. So that can be implemented using the if condition. That is, if of n minus k is greater than or equal to 0 and n minus k is less than lh, then in order to implement the equation, this has to be written in a recursive manner. So rxs of n can be written as equal to rxs of n plus the formula, that is formula is x of k into element by element multiplication has to be done, so dot into star into y of n minus k plus 1. So in MATLAB index cannot be 0, so y of 0 is not invalid. So in order to avoid the condition, n minus k plus 1 is given, and if has to be ended with an end, for also has to be ended with an end statement, and also the result can be again displayed using the DISP function. Now in order to plot the graphs, again considering each element, so the sequence has to be plotted. So let us consider variable a equal to taking the length of the sequence, so 0 to lx minus 1. Now dividing the graph into 3 rows, 2 columns, and plotting in the first area, stem of ax will give you the discrete sequence, will be plotted with a as the x-axis and x as the y-axis. Title y label x label is used to label and title it. Similarly, considering to plot the second sequence, so take a variable b equal to 0 to length of the second variable, that is lh minus 1. As we are starting from 0, this has to be taken as lh minus 1. Again, subplot in the second area, then stem of ah. Now c length is dependent on the final sequence, so that is minus lx plus 1 to lx minus 1. Again, plot it in the third area. So plot both the built-in function and without the built-in function. So all the variables, all the cross-correlation functions has been plotted. Once you debug and run in the MATLAB and giving the sequences 3, 4, 5, 6 and 1, 3, 4, 5, the result obtained is like this, which is the same as that is obtained theoretically, and also all the variables are being plotted, that is the first sequence. So this figure window is divided into 3 rows and 2 columns. So here first plot has been plotted here x, second sequence has been plotted as y, and using the built-in function and using x curve function, this has been plotted. Now in the third, fourth variable, whatever is considered, we have given subplot as 3, 2 and then 5 to 6 has been given. So both the columns will be considered, that is 5th area and 6th area will be considered. So the total is plotted over here. So do share, like and subscribe the channel for latest updates.